Orangutans are endangered and need tropical forest to survive. If they're endangered, then we should try to save them. If they need tropical forest to survive, then we should try to conserve tropical forest. So we should try to save them and try to conserve tropical forest. Sounds simple enough, but even a proof like this can seem intimidating when you're first getting started. Let's work it backward, starting with the conclusion and moving up the proof from there. We need to prove S and C, so let's put it down here, where we eventually want to arrive. Okay, now what would I need in order to get S and C? Well, I'd probably need S on a line and C on a line, like this. That way, I could put them together using the inference rule of conjugation to arrive at S and C. But a new question arises. Where would the S and C come from? Probably up here in lines 2 and 3. But to break out that C from line 3, we would need an F for modus ponens. Let's go ahead and put it in. And to free up that S from line 2, we would need E for modus ponens. So let's put that in too. But now we have to ask, where would that E come from? There it is, up here in line 1. We can break that off using the rule of simplification. Let's jot that down now. We got this E using simp on line 1. And the same goes for this F. We broke it off from line 1 using simplification. Since these lines are all filled out, we can number them now. So far, so good. But we still have to explain how that S got there. Remember, we planned on getting it from here using modus ponens. But to do so, we need E. And we do have E. It's right here down in line 4. So there it is. We got this S using modus ponens, lines 2 and 4. Modus ponens was how we got C, too. We broke it off from line 3 up here. To do that, we needed F, of course, but that's okay because we had it right here in line 5. So, MP, lines 3 and 5. Let's just clean this up a bit by adding the numbers. And we're just about done. In fact, now that I look at it, we are done. We just need to add this 8 and make clear where we got the S and C from, lines 6 and 7. So we've proved what we wanted to prove, and we did it without hunting around blindly using trial and error to find our way through the proof. That is the power of working backward.